Welcome to UK Gamer Network. I'm Stefan, and this is Wolverblade. So Wolverblade is a side-scrolling beat-em-up, sort of like Golden Axe and Street of Rage. So we have four options. Well, I say options. We have the campaign, the arenas, the options, and extras. Now the extras are full of concept art, how the game sort of became a thing. So we've got the intro for level 1 and the outro for level 1. Here is some of the concept art. So we've got how one of the characters became a thing, and then we've got the rangers. So it's really cool stuff like that. And then further down we have the location videos. So they talk about like how they came about to the design of some of the levels in the game. So we'll be looking at Castle Rig for this review and talking a bit about it. So we've got pictures of Hagnot Pass, which is where some of the level was based off. So it's really nice, high quality pictures of the landscape, and then we've got the Lake District, some pictures of the Lake District, some of the landscapes, something you can work off, and then Scottish Forest, and then I believe, is there any more? No. So we've got the history and story as well. So we've got the history note of the Gladius weapon that Michael Heald, the creative director, took and did a little bit of a write up. As it says at the bottom here, the historical research conducted for Wolverblade has been done by Michael Heald, the creative director over a 5-year period. He's very passionate about ancient British history, and he's made sure that it's all accurate. So like, let's just go back to the concept art. Now what I learned from looking at the concept art is they went very sort of cartoony but kept that really gritty serious tone in, as you can see, as we will see again in the game. But they tried to keep it very colourful to appeal, but not too colourful and cartoony that like people who actually do care about the history are like, ugh, this is horrible, it's all cartoony and stuff. So they tried to get that perfect combination in, mixture. So here's, I believe, all the characters, and the wolves, and two kids, I don't know what part of the story they were in. So we're going to jump into the campaign. We've got two different modes, actually. We have normal, and then the arcade mode. The arcade mode, 3 lives, 3 continues, the old school way. And if you run out of those 3 continues... I think it's game over. So it has that hardcore style that people who played Golden Axe and games like that will remember. I'm just going to jump into the normal mode, and we get met with a small loading screen to introduce us to the characters. So first off we have Guinevere. Guinevere is not very strong, not very defensive, but really agile and very fast. So you'd have to bear those in mind when picking characters. We have Bredas, the big bulky powerhouse. I bet he lifts whole trees up, dragging them for firewood. He's very strong, but very slow and very bad with defense. Then we have Caradoc. Caradoc is pretty much as rounded as you can get. He's quite strong, quite fast, and his defense is above everybody else. Now, I'm not sure if we unlock more characters, but I'm only early into the game because I've not really had too much time to play. So we're going to go with Caradoc. And now we get met with a loading screen. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to fast forward to... Oh wait, I've got to choose. So I'm going to just do the Caledonia Woodland level 1. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to select this and then I'm going to pause. Not pause. I'm just going to cut the video and fast forward to when we get into the game. Okay, and we're back. So at the start of the level, you have sort of like the storyline. I'm going to skip it just so you guys can enjoy it in your own time so that there's no spoilers. So now we are in, as you can see, I'm now controlling. We have two attacks, but at this moment I can only show you the one, which is the light attack. There is a heavy attack, but you need to get there's some story notes here. But you need to get a heavy weapon, which I don't have currently, so I'm just going to carry it. So here, normally you would have to kill the story, but I somehow got away with it. So here are our friends, and here's the bad guys. So like most side-scroller beat-em-ups, you have to kill the bad guys to progress. And like I said, the art style is very good, and I have to admit it's probably one of the most violent video games I've ever known Nintendo say yeah, put it on our console to, which is really cool. So, you just saw some wolves.
Please help!
Also,
you find a fire spit,
I believe it's called a spit,
but not a fellow Briton.
You can pick up
own.
The food off
these
it.
These southern tribes now knelt before the evil of Rome,
up.
A treachery that could not
now, in a minute
body.
We'll get introduced to the wolves. I don't know how I did that stab attack. I should have blocked that. You can probably hear me button bashing. I'm very sorry about that, guys. So, there is an arena mod, which Brian, I believe, spoke about in his first mod. I'm not going to really show you that because he's already covered it. But it's basically just like this, but instead of moving the side-scrolling part, you just stay at that level and it gets harder and harder, which I really like personally. I think it's a cool concept, like just constantly like beating through waves of these guys. I completely screwed. Oh, there's a ladder there. Just found one of the ladders just under here. Ah. Oh wow, I thought it would be a heavy weapon this big fat lax. Apparently not. So yeah, I believe Brian covered the arena mod. So I'm not gonna talk that much about it, but I really do like the concept. So there's the wolves. Despite him killing those two guys, you do get to call them again by pressing ZR, which is also known as R2 for PS4 or right trigger for Xbox players. So as you can see the arrow
crawl
pointing
back into the woods
right.
Where you belong, wild one. Say hello to some good friends of mine.
Sadly, I can't like run when I've got hold of this battle axe. Oh wow! Oh wow! It's really strong. Nice. So you can pick up. Oh wow! It's like really bad with durability. So the durability system, I tend to say, is a lot like Breath of the Wild. Like, but it started blinking red to say, "Yo, I'm low durability." Like Zelda, it says, "Your Master Sword." I know it doesn't say Master Sword, but for example. Your Master Sword is on low durability, and it's about to break. Oh wow, did I really just impale him on a spike? Nice.
The North
so,
was
another
a savage
feature
land,
that this game has,
an unforgiving
which I can't
landscape
quite like,
that only
is the
rage hardiest
mechanic
could survive.
So, I'm going to press L now.
The tribes to face,
and I,
for they challenge the Earth
I get my
herself.
Tomahawk, and I do. I just. Slaughter these guys with them. If I could actually get a good hit on them. Which I didn't, because I suck at this game. I really, really hate the rages in this game. So here's some food again, pick it up and eat it. I'm gonna pick up this woman's head because I'm a beast and I can do what I want. But this guy said he's cute. Oh wow! What the? Oh wow! I did not know, so I'm pressing Y and B together. I don't know what it does. Does it hurt me or something? Right. So cool, I've got some sort of like rage attack sort of thing. AoE. That is really useful to know. Bit too strong in my opinion. Go away. Oh, I don't think I can use it anymore. Since that big so unless it's a nice juicy steak. Bet even these guys enjoyed a big fat juicy steak. So vegans, if there's any watching. It'd sound a bit weird to say like big fat juicy salad. Or would it? But anyway, so I've spoken about the art style, now the music. I really like music. Like being someone who's quite deaf, I find the music really nice. I have to have it on loud, but I really do like it. It matches the game quite well. So I'm going to do my rage again, because this is going to be quite a big battle. absolutely wreck that guy. Oh, what's this? Oh wow, I can rage again, nice. Away, Ranger. Who would have think I've got something against Rangers? I suppose I'd do it this way. They're like really strong. Like, I have. Like, sure. Like, if there's nothing, no challenge, what's the point of really playing the game? So, in a few minutes now, we'll be hitting the boss. Now, I only know this because I played this level before. Yeah, I think after this is... No. Who is it? It's not a strange tree, so I'm a bit nice. Fit the next screen. We get the boss. I believe that all of the like bad guys have a name. Like a unique name. Like we do with our usernames. I owe you my life, my friends.
We might need assistance.
Convenient meat placement. I think the AI is sometimes a little bit weird. So I believe this is the... Yes. This is the boss battle. I'll skip so that you guys can enjoy the story yourselves.
Too far north, southerner. This is no place for you. The Tiburis claim this land in the name of Rome. Kneel, or... You think you can take this land?
So, this guy has two health bars.
Northern dog!
I could call these abilities for help. Has that even hit me real life? No, no, we took one of his health bars off. And now... Yeah, I just left me to use the last health bar.
The Tiburis will destroy you!
I actually failed that. You can continue from the checkpoint, but I'm not gonna. So, my overall opinion on Wolverine Blade is definitely pick it up if you liked stuff like Golden Axe, Streets of Rage. It's a lot like that. And I know I probably don't do it justice because I'm really bad at the game. Like, I'll admit it. But I really enjoy it and I just want to keep playing it to get better. I know that it doesn't look like I've played much, but that's because I've not had much time. I definitely think this is a pickup for Switch users. Like, you can find it on the Nintendo eShop, which I'm going to show you. So I believe it's in the recent releases. There it is. It says purchased for me, but you can pick it up for $19.99 if you are in the USA, or I believe it's something like $16.99. The version that I'm playing now was a review copy sent by Darkwind Media. It was free. I do believe I need to disclose that. Yes, it's £15 on the Nintendo eShop. I do believe it's coming to Switch. And I believe it's on Switch, PC, and it's coming to Xbox and PS4. So overall, I definitely say pick it up if you've got a spare £15. You could definitely just pick it up and play it. It does give you in-game tutorial with no hand-holding. I know some people say, oh, it holds your hand too much. It really doesn't. It throws you in the deep end with the tutorial sort of woven in. But yeah, £15 on the eShop or your regional equivalent.